Hello everyone, this is Payal Vaja. Welcome to Pharma Desert. In this video, we will discuss about Schedule M Part 1. So let's get started. First of all, introduction. Requirement of factory premises, allopathic drugs which give the conditions with which premises license for the manufacture of drug it should conform. So what is the introduction of Schedule M? Schedule M, that is stand for good manufacturing practice. So requirement of any factory premises, particularly for allopathic drugs, that give the conditions with which premises that is directly licensed for the manufacturing of drug, it should conform. Part 1, which is a general requirements for a premises. First one, location or surrounding. So in location, factory should not situated to an open sewage, any drainage, otherwise public lavatory, or any factory which produce a disagreeable odor or fumes. So location that is only surrounded in sanitary place. So location or surrounding, in location or surrounding, we already discussed factory shouldn't situated in any type of open sewage, otherwise any type of drain, public lavatory or any factory, they produce any type of disagreeable odors, otherwise fumes. But factory, it should be located in sanitary place. Second one, what about building? So in building, it should permit production under the hygienic conditions and the premises should not be used for sleeping purpose. So in building, first one, it should permit the production and production that is done under the hygienic condition only. And premises that should not be used for sleeping purpose. So the wall of room shall have a height of 6 feet from floor and it should be smooth, waterproof and cleanable. So what about building? First one, production should be done under the hygienic condition. Second one, premises shouldn't used for any type of sleeping purpose, otherwise drinking or watering purpose. And the wall of room, it shall have height about 6 feet from the floor and it should be smooth, waterproof and cleanable. Flooring. What about flooring? Flooring shall be smooth as well as washable and adequate lighting, ventilation and humidity that must be maintained. Next one, drainage system should be underground. So next step, adequate lighting, ventilation as well as humidity must be maintained according to plan. And second one, drainage system should be maintained but it should be underground. And the sanitary fitting and electrical fixture, it should be concealed. So adequately, space that is provided for the placement of equipments, materials as well as movement of person, so avoid the risk of mixing, contamination and cross contamination. So in last step, optimum space that is required for the placement of any equipments, any materials and movement of person, due to that reason avoid the risk of mixing, contamination and cross contamination. What about water supply? So water used, it shall be pure and of drinkable quality as well as that is free from pathogen. So if you are using water, or what about water supply? So water that is used, it shall be pure in nature as well as that have a drinkable quality and free from all the pathogens. So validated system for the treatment of water, that is also required in any plant. Next one, disposal of waste. What about disposal of waste? Waste that is disposed of after a suitable pre-treatment to make it harmless. And it should be according to Environment Pollution Control Board. So what about disposal of waste? First of all, waste that is disposed of after pre-treatment and make it completely harmless. And that is done, or that is decided based on Environment Pollution Control Board. and record shall be maintained of disposal of rejected drug. So if disposal of drug that are rejected, so record should be maintained. And proper and safe storage of waste material awaiting disposal. What about warehousing area? In warehousing area, adequate areas for various categories of material and products like starting material, packaging material, intermediate product, bulk product, finished dosage form, product in quarantine area, released material, return material, as well as machine and equipment spare parts. So in warehousing area, adequate space or adequate area that is required for various category of material like starting material or raw material, packaging material, intermediate products, any bulk or bulk product, any finished dosage form, as well as machine and equipment spare part, all have specific area for storage. Second one, separate sampling area in the warehousing area for API and excipients. So next step, separate sampling area that is needed. Why? Because in sampling area, API and excipients are stored. Second one, hazardous, poisonous, flammable, as well as narcotics that are directly stored in safe and secure area. That means if any hazardous product or if product that have any flammable product have flammable in nature or explosive in nature and narcotic drug substance, all are stored in safe and secure area. That means all are stored in lock and key area, lock and key with cupboard. Separate dispensing areas for sexual hormones as well as cytotoxic substance and beta-lactam hormones, beta-lactam antibiotics. Sampling and dispensing of sterile materials it shall be conducted under the accepting condition. That means sampling and dispensing of any sterile product, they should be directly conducted under the aseptic condition. If aseptic condition not maintained, so in that case, sampling or dispensing of sterile material that is not performed. In storage area, separate space that is required for under the test, approved and rejected. What about production area? In production area, it should allow the production in uniflow and with logical sequence of operations. So separate dedicated facilities it shall be provided for the production of contamination and which causing and potent products sex hormones. So first one, in production area, according to their name, it should allow the production in uniflow as well as with logical sequence of operations. And second one, separate facilities it shall be provided for the production of contamination causing and potent product sex hormones. So separate facilities that is provided for any product that produce any type of contamination, otherwise any potent drug substance, they are separately manufactured. All service lines that is directly identified by colors as well as nature of supply and direction of flow. What about ancillary area? In ancillary area, rest and refreshment rooms shall be separate from other area. That means in ancillary area, rest rooms shall be separated from manufacturing, otherwise storage area. So this shall not lead directly to manufacturing and storage area. In facilities, in ancillary area, which type of facilities that is available? Facilities for changing, facilities for storing the clothes and for washing and toilet purpose, it shall be easily accessible. So toilets that is separate for males and females. So first of all, what about ancillary area? In ancillary area, rest and refreshment room, it should be separate from the manufacturing, otherwise storage area. And which type of facilities that is maintained in ancillary area? So facilities like changing room, storing clothes and for washing and toilet purpose shall be easily accessible. And a toilet that are separate from for males and females. maintenance workshop shall be separate and away from production area. So one type of a workshop it should be maintained, but it should be separate and away from production area. So housing animal shall be isolated from other area. If you have animal house, so housing animal, it shall be isolated from manufacturing or storage area or production area or warehousing area. Next one, what about quality control area? According to their name, what is the role of quality control area? They control quality of any dosage form. So it should be independent of production areas, separate laboratory for physicochemical, biological and microbiological product. So quality control area, it is independent of all the production area. And that have a separate laboratories for any physicochemical product as well as biological product, or if any microbiological product. Separate instrument shall be provided for each laboratory. In personnel, what about personnel? So manufacture shall be conducted under the direct supervision of competent technical staff. If you are performing any type of manufacturing or you are prepared any type of dosage form, so in that case manufacturing that is done under the direct supervision of competent technical staff. And the head of quality control lab shall be independent of manufacturing and testing that is carried out under the direct supervision of staff. And the next step, after manufacturing, head of quality control lab that are independent of manufacturing, they only quality control in charge have only duty about testing of any dosage form. Next one, health, clothing and sanitary requirements of staff. So what about health, clothing and sanitary requirements of any staff members? All staff or workers should be free from contagious disease. So first of all staff or any worker, it should be completely free from any contagious disease or not. Second one, their clothing should be white or colored uniform and clean. So staff members have one type of uniform system. So that uniform, it should be clean and otherwise white or colored uniform, and it should be clean. Adequate facilities that is required for personal cleanliness, such as clean towels, clean soaps and hand scrubbing, all should be provided. So what about health, clothing and sanitary requirements for any staff members? First one, staff members that are free from any contagious disease. Second one, their clothing shall be white, otherwise colored uniform and clean. Second one, adequate facilities that is requirement for personal cleanliness, such as clean towel, soaps or hand scrubbing, all shall be provided. Next one, change clean footwear before entering in manufacturing unit, and the workers shall require to wear a headgear. So first one, change the clean footwear before enter in into your production area, and worker shall require to wear a headgear for protection. And the person engaged in parenteral product, mask should be provided. So if a person that is directly engaged in any parenteral product preparation, in that case mask should be provided to person. And the personal handling beta-lactam shall be tested for penicillin sensitivity, and handling sex hormones as well as cytotoxic substance and any potent drug shall be periodically examined for ADR. So if any person they directly handle any beta-lactam product, any sex hormones, cytotoxic drug substance or any potent drug substance, so staff members, that type of staff member or that type of person directly examined for adverse drug reaction. and as well as smoking, drinking or chewing shall not be permitted in production as well as laboratory and storage area. What about medical services? In medical services, adequate facilities for first aid. So, particular specific facilities that is required for first aid and medical inspection at a time of employment and periodical. In medical service, second point, that is medical inspection that is required at the time of employment. Otherwise, and the second one that is also required periodically, like 6 months medical inspection or at 1 year medical inspection. Safeguarding, including industrial accident. So safeguarding that is maintained in case of if any type of industrial accident that is occur. Sterile product. In sterile products, separate enclosed area provided with airlocks, dust-free, ventilated with air supply through HEPA filter are recommended. So in sterile products, separate area that is provided, and in separate area, airlock system is available, particularly in sterile product. For sterile product preparation or sterile product manufactured, sterile product manufactured area, that is one type of separate area, and maintain a aseptic condition in sterile product preparation area, and area that is provided with airlock system, it should be dust free, and that is ventilated with air supply through HEPA filter, which are recommended. And air supply that is done with the help of HEPA filter. What is HEPA filter? That is high efficiency particulate airflow. So during the manufacturing, microbial counts of area, it should be necessary. Design of area should preclude the mix-up of sterile as well as non-sterile product. So design of area, it should preclude about mix-up of any sterile or non-sterile product. Next one, manufacturing operation and control. What about manufacturing operation and control? So all manufacturing operation, it shall be carried out under the supervision of technical staff that is already approved by licensing authority. So manufacturing operation that is done by or that is carried out only under the supervision of any technical staff members and technical staff members that is approved by licensing authority. All vessels and container that is directly used in manufacturing and storage, it shall be labeled with name of product, batch number, batch size and stage of each manufacturing. So all vessels or container that are used in manufacturing as well as storage purpose, it shall be labeled with name of product, batch number, batch size and stages of manufacturing. Each label, it should be signed and that is dated by authorized technical and that is dated by authorized technical staff. Precautions against mix-up and cross-contamination that is maintained. So any type of precautions that is maintained particularly for avoid mixing and avoid cross-contamination. Packaging lines shall be independent and that is separated from other area. And environment shall be maintained at a required level of temperature as well as humidity and cleanliness. So what about environment? Environment it should be maintained at a optimum level of temperature as well as humidity and maintain a cleanliness. What about raw materials? In raw materials, identified, all the raw materials should be identified and their containers that is directly examined for damage and assign a control number. So all the raw materials that are directly identified and if there have any type of damage that is examined properly, it is stored at a optimum temperature and relative humidity, and a label should indicate about name of material, control number as well as name of manufacturer, and last one under the test, approved the test or rejected, and systematically sampled for quality control testing. So sample that is given for quality control testing. and release from a quarantine area by quality control personnel through a written instruction, and arrange such that first in and first out system. So rejected material that are destroyed or that are returned to the supplier directly. That is about raw material. What about equipment? In equipment, it should be constructed, designed, installed and maintained to desired quality, as well as which prevent the contact of lubricants, which prevent the physical chemical changes through the surface, and facilitate through cleaning. Written cleaning or operational instruction should be available, that is SOP. So what about equipment? So equipment should be constructed, designed, installed and maintained to desired quality, as well as which prevent the physicochemical change through any type of surface, and prevent the contact of lubricant, and they facilitate through cleaning. So written cleaning, otherwise operational instruction, it should be available, and that are called as standard operating procedure. What about documentation and records? So it is an essential part of quality assurance and related to good manufacturing practice. So documents, it should be designed, prepared, reviewed and controlled. So documentation, that is a one type of essential part for quality assurance, and that is related to good manufacturing practice. Documents that are designed properly, prepared, reviewed and controlled effectively, as well as documents shall be approved, signed and dated by appropriate as well as authorized person. And documents, it defines a specification for all the materials, methods of manufacturing as well as control. So records shall be completed at the time of each operation, and records and SOP shall be written for once in a year after the expiry date. So what about documentation? First of all, that is the essential part of quality assurance related to GMP. It directly defines the specification of all the materials, method of manufacturing as well as control, and documents that are designed properly, prepared, reviewed and controlled. Documents shall be approved as well as that is signed and that is dated by any appropriate and authorized person only. And record shall be completed at the time of each operation. So record and SOP both are written for once in a year after the expiry date. Next one, what about labels and other printed materials? So in case of labels, the printed material, it should be stored such that they do not become intermixed. So printed materials that are directly stored in where they do not become intermixed. Second one, prior to issue all the labels circular, insert and leaflets should be examined and released as satisfactory for use by quality control. That is about labels and other printed materials. So in labels and other printed materials should be stored such that they do not become intermixed, as well as prior to issue all the labels, circulars, as well as insert and leaflets, all should be examined properly, and that is released as satisfactory for use by quality control personnel. And upon completion of packaging and labeling operation, a comparison should be made. What type of comparison that is done? That is made between the number of labeling and packaging unit issued and number of units labeled as well as packed. So unused, any coded and spoiled labels and packaging material, it should be destroyed by comparing it. If any query or doubts related to topic, please write your questions in comment box. Thank you.